Welcome back. Initializing.
Warning, currency of unknown origin detected.
Hype engine spinning up. %25. Stand by. Star clusters inbound, engaging scratch-resistant nanofilm. %50. Warning, your activity has been broadcast. %75. Personal hydration at optimum levels. Hype engines at maximum. Transmission complete. 100%.
Hey, lovely people, welcome to the stream. I'm Quiet Hydra, and I'm so glad to see you here tonight. Tonight we are going to be playing a little Flame Keeper, which is a new action roguelike that just came out last week, I believe, Thursday or Friday. But of course we were playing Stray, so we kind of had to push it off till today. So we're going to dive into Flame Keeper for today and on Wednesday. So Flame Keeper is an action roguelike where we'll be, you know what, we'll talk about this in a little bit, but we'll be keeping the flames alive as we try to recapture the fire from the evil shadows and nightmares. So we're going to be playing this game all through the night tonight, keeping each other warm and toasty as we explore it, see what it's all about, and just enjoy the game for what it is. I actually played the demo of this one, so this isn't completely like a new game to me. I did play the demo, I loved it, and if you follow me on YouTube, you might have actually seen my demo playthrough of this, as I posted it on there as a part of one of my YouTube exclusive indie first looks. So if you're not aware, my YouTube channel gets exclusive indie first looks more often than the Twitch channel. You might want to subscribe there if you're into indie games. So we have played the demo of this, loved it, wanted to give it some more time to shine and play the full release when it comes out. Here we are, we're gonna play it and we're gonna have fun with it. So with that all out of the way, let's talk a little stream news. So stream news this week: Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 9:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time to 11:30 midnight, depending on how well the night is going, how I'm feeling, and how the games are going. And you know what? I need to check something before we get into anything. Okay. So, depending on how well the games are going and all that kind of stuff, we are going to be going from our... we're going to have our normal schedule this week. I'm really happy about that. Last week was a little scattered and my mind was all over the place, but things are much better. I actually had a checkup today. Sorry, cat. No, don't do that to your brother. No, leave him alone. Anyways, I actually had a checkup today. It went well, so I'm happy. Well, I mean, it kind of went. My blood pressure's high, but I'm not shocked. I'm gonna have to monitor that, but whatever. I'm riding life dangerously. So we are going to be on our regular schedule this week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Things shouldn't be changing, and we're just going to have fun with it, do our cozy little streams, and just enjoy the time together. So that is the plan. Next week might be a little spicy, I don't know. I do have something coming up next week. I just don't have the exact date of it, and depending on what day it lands on, it might interfere with the stream. Hopefully not. We'll see. It might mean like a super duper casual stream, or we might just have to postpone it. But I won't know until the end of this week, or closer to the end of this week. So outside of that, not much more going on. There's more exclusive videos and stuff at my social media accounts, if you want to follow those, like YouTube stuff, things like that. A new video of the exclusive indie first look just came up on my YouTube. It's for Pigship and the Giant Wolf. It's a really crazy side-scrolling shooter 'em up. Super challenging, really a lot of fun. If you are interested in side-scrolling shoot 'em ups that are super duper challenging, check out my YouTube channel for that video after the stream. So let's get into the little Flame Keeper. So Flame Keeper is an action roguelike that, you know, my bread and butter. Action roguelike that has some really cool mechanics. A, it's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. Absolutely, positively gorgeous. You'll see when we get it started. It's just lovely. Absolutely lovely. Just the lighting in this game is amazing. besides that, it is a pretty straightforward action roguelike with some nice little tweaks there here and there. One of the tweaks is you're trying to keep your bonfires alive with using your light. So you have to feed a fire, you have to feed fire with your fire, and fire is your life. And we always have to keep ourselves burning, but we have to sacrifice our life to complete the levels. And it's that balance of how much life do you give up and risk yourself, or do you go in fully like I was in the demo and give up everything and then try your best to survive? It did not go well, but it has a lot of that. It has some role-playing aspects where we could level up, fine-tune things, build a skill tree out. And another cool mechanic, which is something I don't traditionally like, not a knock against this type of gameplay, but it's not one a game that I typically like, but it has a tower defense level mechanic in it. So some levels have some tower defense mechanics, and you have to keep your tower alive while also setting up traps and obstacles and stuff. But that's only like a component, and it's actually pretty fun from what I experienced in the demo. So I'm curious to how much that is going to be involved in the full game, and see where this all goes and see how much replayability this game has. If it has a lot of replayability, we'll probably visit it a lot, and I'll be giving some glowing, see what I did there, glowing reviews of this game. So let's get into some Flamekeeper and see what we can spark up. All right, file the middle. Like, guys, what did I tell you? This thing is pretty, like, absolutely, positively pretty. It's so pretty. All right, we jump over things, we jump over obstacles, we don't have stamina. We dash and we knock these little fireballs off, which heals our health. Those little fireballs are our health. Look at our feet prints. The little fireballs are our health. We can eat shrooms. Let me check the sound volume. It seems okay. Maybe it's a little high. Turn down just a tiny bit. Okay, so we can eat some mushrooms, gives us a little armor. We have light attack. Bam. Nice. I'm trying to balance out my volume here in our tutorial area. All right, so we got a full health right now. Let's go find ourselves. So L2 to open the tome with our energy, so we give it a little bit of our life and we collect some red chili peppers, or at least they look like chili peppers. And here's the bonfire. So this is the cool thing. Your energy drops when you charge the campfire. To fill up the campfire, you need to have collected all the lamps. Zoom out to navigate. So we're going to zoom out here. This is going to be cool. Whoop. Look at it. Oh, it's so awesome game. It's so pretty. And yeah, we have this like on ultra settings, but I don't think it actually requires so much from your computer. All right, so let's give it a little of our fire. And you can see it up there at the top. It shows how much progress from the lamps you're getting. Let's feed it a little bit more. You don't want to go too far. I learned from the demos. You don't want to give it too much of your life. Because, of course, if you give it too much of your life, you are going to be in trouble. So we want to keep our health up pretty nice. Hey, Lloyd, how are you doing? Kicking butt and taking names. That's what we're doing. All right, let's get ourselves a lamp. And anytime we interact with something, it's going to take our life away. So we need to be careful with that balance. Here is a lantern. Collect some more little fireballs. Fill up the campfire and let's vamoose. Killed opponents. Six. We got no big totems. Small totem. Gain seeds. Oh, they're seeds. They're not chili peppers. And no resources. Wait. Oh, riding scooters in the electric scooters in the rain? Does that work? Do they work that way? Or is that like a problem with them? Oh, this is Flamekeeper. Yeah, it's similar to Cult of the Lamb. It's a action roguelike. Oh, whenever it's not raining, you don't use them. Oh. We play ball in this. So this is giving us the lore of the game. We're helping these like little raccoon people out. Or where are they? Kind of like raccoons. All right, village time. Our beloved mother is probably dancing in the woods. Okay. So, in the demo, we didn't get to look too much into this stuff because some of it was blocked out. But now we get to actually look. Use seeds to improve your skills. Upgrade the building to unlock each skill thing. Each stage of skills. So we're like down here. Okay, enjoy your alert. I don't know about enjoying a phone call though. I never enjoy phone calls. Are we a firefighter? One could say we are a firefighter. We are fire. And we are fighting. Oh, that's the dirty south. Let's not go to the dirty south. Okay, where are we going? Okay, so we're upgrading our ignits. Upgrade building, we don't have that. We do have seeds. I don't think we have anything that we can do here. I guess we go for an adventure. All right, let's check out our ruin. What's the ruins look like? So a lot of upgrade stuff we're blocked out of right now. Scrolls. I love me some scrolls. Oh, I need that. We need to go back to this. This is for the YouTube. There we go. We got the... So I could get the sprite for my YouTube. My YouTube cards. All right. Or I guess we're going to start an adventure. Okay, so this is the pathways that we go. We will be going down into Mole's hole. The mole is underground. So if you see his hole, don't fall down. Mole's hole. All right, we're gonna feed it a little of our health. Just a taste. It doesn't need all of our health. Just a little. A sampling of health. Oh yeah, regeneration's pretty good. These little ground creatures are obnoxiously evil. Oh! Oh no! I hit one of the raccoon people! Whoopsie! The nice thing about the raccoon people, so they'll come out of their little homes and they'll collect the little flames that you leave on the ground. And they will collect them and then put them in a box near their house. And you could go back and get those flame balls. So it's almost like they're prepping supplies for you. So there we go. What's weird is we don't have like the dash, I don't think. Oh no, we do have a dash. Ah! I forgot we have a dash. And I absolutely love that we can do the finishing moves. Okay, we need this flame totem. Ah! Okay, fast bullets. Fire a few scattered fire bullets. And let's also get this as a weapon. Okay, but first we gotta get this lamp. I guess we will take the lamp over the weapon. We don't need the weapon. No! No! Stay away from me! I do like we could use the lamp as a weapon. It's not like you're sacrificing your ability to do stuff. Alright, regeneration's pretty sweet. Give it a little health. Need to find some fireballs. Ah! Please don't take that. Okay, I'm gonna go back and get that red thing. I've only known this as a weapon. I don't know if it's something I could turn in. I remember these in the demo and I never figured out what they are. Okay, I think they're just a weapon. Which, I mean, fair. I'll take a weapon. Get that pound town going. Nope. It does slow us down from dashing though. Alright. We got that going. Get back there, dude. Those are my fireballs. And these monsters will just keep spawning. So it's never going to be a moment of rest for you. You're constantly fighting them off. Which honestly, I kind of prefer. Makes for a more combat focused game. Goodbye. Oh, do I want this back? I want it back. I don't know what it is, but I'm going to use it. Would you like this? It's a big red flamey thing. Oh, it's a rune. Find rune to open totem. Okay. So we do need it. It's not just a big flaming red thing. It's something we need. Well, that is a bonanza. I think we go back. Yeah, we go back. We feed it our life force a little bit. and then we go to town. Oh my gosh. Can I have a moment? So many of them. Too many. This is one thing I liked about the game when I was playing the demo, is the enemy do not leave you alone. They constantly are coming after you. It can be very very intense sometimes. Let's hand over some life force. We're trying to be as balanced as possible, but I am taking a little bit of risk because I'm all about that risk. No. Knock a tree. Oh dear. Oh dear. Collect those balls. Oh my gosh, please come out of the ground, please. Thank you. We'll just finish it. I'm really actually looking forward to getting past the stuff that I'm familiar with and seeing later stuff. Because there was things that we saw in the demo that were very hinting at some really cool mechanics or enemy situations that I am looking forward to seeing. See how they all panned out. Oh gosh. These little caterpillar things are trouble. Okay, let's do that. We'll get that. We'll go over here. Take a little shortcut. Fire it up, and I think we got everything. We should be good. Level 2. Those are mine. I like the little creatures that are constantly trying to help you by collecting the balls. But sometimes it's like, hey, I need the hooks right this second. Make sure there's no spiders up there. Okay. Sometimes there's spiders that hide in the roofs or in the branches. Oh no. Okay, we're low on life, so let's sacrifice some. All right, let's see what they collected. Not a ton. Unfortunately, we don't have anything to give to the bonfire. Okay, what does melting do? Creates a spherical deadly heat area. Okay. We'll bring down the spider. I don't want to accidentally punch those things again, but they're like running around so much. No! No! We might have flown too close to the sun there. But we got it back in the bag. We got it back in the bag. Collect those. Get our lantern. Put lantern down for a minute. Do, 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 do. I'm not gonna light it up yet. Let me punch you. There we go. We're running a little low on, we're running kind of hot on life. So this is kind of risky. But I'm okay with the risk at this moment. I think we have enough here to... Let's not do that one. Yeah, we'll have enough to heal up pretty well. We just gotta be careful. Everything uses our stamina or health. So we're constantly in that balance. Balance is not on my side. A good upgrade will help. I think one of the first upgrades I'll probably want to grab is ideally something that helps with like stamina. The more we could jump and dash, the better, in my opinion. There you are. Oh, big old caterpillar. Okay, where is everything? Oops, where is everything? So we got that lantern. There's the room. We don't necessarily need the room right now. Like, the rune would be nice. We don't need it, though. We don't even know where the rune temple, where the temple is. I mean, we'll take it. Because I think it's over that way. Put that down. Get some armor. Stand back! Oh, jeez. No, please don't take those. We got a ton of seeds. We got more seeds than we know what to do with. Okay, that's another lamp. Okay, there's the temple. Oh, I punched him again! I'm sorry about that, little dude. Okay, now we get this. We gotta get those acorns, man. Lock her in. Sweet, sweet acorns. Oh, okay. All right, this is lamp number two, or lamp number four. Then we just need to light up this fire. Please don't bother me, caterpillar. We're just going all in. We'll go downstairs with, or we'll go to the next level with less life. Defend the storage. Okay, so this is the tower defense that I was talking about. So we have to defend the main storage, and we have to use our energy to create obstacles while also fighting off the enemy. It's pretty crazy. Especially seeing I'm not like a tower defense person, but I actually found myself really enjoying this one. The problem is just not getting enough health stuff here. Flying Fists of Fury! Alright. Trap number one set. Okay, that's to slow things down. Oh, we just need a tad bit more. There we go. Regeneration's really good here. Creatures of the night. All right, we'll get another tower there. We're gaining so much stuff. The shield's okay. Where are they coming from? I hear them. Oh, there they are. Let's get Hammer Strike. Hammer Strike sounds good. All right, that should slow things down on this end. We need to hurry up here. Oh no! Stop running! All right, that should slow things down there. Okay, we're all good there. Where are they coming from? It is a very cool game. I really enjoyed the demo, and getting to play the full release has been something I've been looking forward to. Be gone, creatures! Okay, this is the big push. No! I'll read what's going on. I need to deal with this real quick. The good thing there is, I think they're coming after me. There we go. I think it's always going to be adorable. I think it's always going to be adorable. Who knows? It might get tougher. More stern. I haven't got to a point where we've gotten to upgrade yet. So, who knows? The skies are the limit. But I'm for it being cute. Okay, we got acorns. Oh, so we could build level one stuff now. Nice. Increase punch damage. Dash deals damage. Let's go increase punch damage for now. I like their building things. Go to the campfire and complete the biome Windy Desert to unbind this district. Okay, that is our loot. Totems, seeds, cone, and spikes. Royal North. Go to the campfire and complete the biome of Waterfall Clouds. Eating shrooms. Okay, so that tells us what all the shrooms do. Mud layer. That's another biome. Tower. Bring energy and receive help from tower defense. Use resources to improve building level. Upgrade Vulpus. Oh, they're Vulpus. Damage. Shrooms are always good. Let's see. I guess we could go more in on our skills. Yeah, I think we can, for the tower defense stuff, it looks like we could upgrade how the tower defense components work. Which is pretty cool. Alright, we don't have enough acorn. Let's do dash power. We dabbled in both. This tells us about our scrolls. This is runes, but we don't have that yet. Oh no, we can do this. Yes. Oh, we can pick one. Add runes to slots to gain better performance. Increase slot limit by upgrading the building. Nice. Okay, what do we do? Lucky punch, 10% chance of a 200% critical hit. The one punch, pacifist, 8% chance of dodging the attack. A glory kill can be performed sooner. 20% more damage when low health. Increased health gathered from energy probes. That's actually pretty nice. Magneto, 100% greater collection range. Collection range might be good too. These two are actually on my list of probably early grabs. Quicker speed, less chance of negative effect from mushrooms, higher attack knockback, movement faster by 15% when full, longer dash, give more health points, better energy, less energy loss when charging the main campfire. 20% slower energy loss and survival. Untouchable, immune to mob damage while charging a campfire. That's cool. I kind of want Magneto. Oh, do we not have access to this yet? Oh, I guess we don't have runes. So that's a thing. We don't have runes yet. But when we do, oh boy. When we do, we're coming for it. All right, let's go to this strange seed. There is a dangerous seed, so smash the flower for it to be freed. Okay, we're doing the poems now. All right, now we're in the territory of I don't know about it, because this was not in the demo. Okay, we got the two lamps. Let's go after this one. Just seems like an easier lamp to go for. Lava pool spills lava around Ignis and inflicts damage to nearby enemies. Yeah, we'll take that. I want to make a lava pool. That box is stuffed. Yeah, we'll take the movement speed. We'll go halvies on that. What? That was very weird. Alright, we'll grab the rune. I don't know where this rune can go. Yo! The creatures are very Starship Troopers. Alright, let's do this. Grab the lamp, bring it home. We'll refill too while we're at it. Pretty straightforward level. Come on. Oh no, we already been here. Okay, here we are. Oh. This thing keeps on our tail. We need to get rid of it. Got it, little Vulpal. Get away! Okay, so there is our temple. Oops, did not want to trigger that yet, but here we are. Put that there. We'll use regeneration to our benefit right now. Oh no! Oh no! Oh, come on! No! This is mine! My rune! Alright, I'm cool with them following me. I'm totally fine with this. This is fine. Everything's fine. Bam! Give me them acorns! Oh my gosh, the little eyes in the tree. We'll also get this while we're here. I like this game. It proves that you could be a very neon game without being cyberpunk. But still bringing, not even a cyberpunk game, and I'm still bringing the neon here. That's what I love best. Ooh, those things like really are good at predicting where I'm gonna walk. Open, open. Collect runes. Oh, that's interesting. So we got 1 out of 4 lucky punch. And then we could add it to an open slot. Interesting. That is way more. That is a little way deeper than I expected that to be. I'm for it. Well, he fell down the cliff. All right, let's get this thing started. Unfortunately, we can't feed it all the way through. The good thing is there's plenty of these energy balls around. That's almost 3. Alright, so that's 3. If this is regenerate, that'd be perfect. It is. Thank you. Hit him! I didn't mean to hit you, man! You keep running to where I want to be! That's my moose. Okay, we're gonna do this. I'm gonna go on my first break of the night, and when we be back, we'll continue this new section. So 3 minutes, be right back, and we'll get back into Firekeeper. All right. Let's just wait 5 more seconds. And then, back in. Okie dokie. Welcome back, everyone. Let's heat things up and get into more fire here. What I've been really enjoying as of right now is how fast this game can be done. And what I mean is, like, everything's moving so fast. It's a very quick game. Finish! Okay, so we got this. There's the lamp. There's the rune. There's another little thing there. Oh, shoot. Okay, so there is the temple. So let's do the rune first. No, we don't jump as far with the holding things, though. There we go. Come and get it. All right, first lamp has been lit up. Get away, get away, get away. I don't need your help, little guys. All right, we don't need that thing anymore. We're fine. Well, we already got lava pool. Oh, wait. Precise pool. I don't know if I like precise bullet. We'll find out. But we won't know what scrolls we like until we try them. Ooh, there's a second lucky punch. Oh, that didn't help! Oh my gosh! Precise bullet has failed us. Alright, we should be good. Nope, nope. Oh no, where's the campfire? Oh, there it is. Okay. We'll fill up the lamp about halfway. All right, precise bullet is probably not going to help us in a large combat. I think it's to take out far away enemies. Probably not something we want to utilize in a brawl. There's our other lamp. Ooh, there's the other one too. Okay. Oh no, we already got that one. You have one more ember to find? Hold on. Oh! Oh no! Are you using, is there a walkthrough? There should be a walkthrough through it. What ember are you looking for? Because I kind of remember... I kind of remember where some of them are. Like, some of the campfire puzzles were a little tricky, if I recall. That's a playthrough I wish I had saved. How are you liking the last campfire? I know we talked about it a little bit. Oops! I remember loving this. The story was so nice and sweet. Okay, what am I doing? We got the lamp, two lamps from here. We need to find another lamp over here. But I remember some of the embers were really weird to solve. It took me a minute to get the 100%. In a dark passage. Oh. Yeah, I don't recall that one. I remember the ones that were giving me trouble. And most of the ones that were giving me trouble is I just wasn't thinking about it too hard. It's always so easy, though. Sometimes it's like the easiest thing to find. You need like step away for a minute to look. Yeah, I really like Last Campfire. The story was really nice. Even had little moments I wasn't expecting, which is always cool. What game are you thinking about playing after that one? Yeah, I remember some puzzles, it's like, oh, this is a really challenging one. And it turned out to be like a really easy puzzle. It's just, I was putting way too much effort into thinking it. Uh-oh. All right, last one. I don't want to go full in. We don't want to go to the tower defense with really low life. So let's go farm some life. Oh, fireball, no! All right, just a little bit more. Get our health up really big. I remember the game that had the puzzles that always like got me really kind of out of sorts was Tunic. That one had some really interesting puzzles where it's like the answer was right in front of you the whole time. Baba Is You is really fun. I had so much fun with that game. I had a friend that suggested it to me. And we did do it on stream. We did play it on stream, and it was just a ton of fun. If you like puzzle games, it is super fun. And it can be really challenging. In a good way. Oh my gosh, they're still coming up from here. The spooners! Okay, we got this one figured out. Almost. Oh my gosh. I'm going so dangerous right now. I feel like I'm kind of risking it all with how low my HP is right now. Ooh, there's our second or third lucky punch. You know what? We'll take that. We'll take that. Okay, we'll build a tower, finish the spikes. I'm not too worried about getting the slime stuff. Get wrecked! Come on! We need it! I need this life! Alright, tower ready. Gosh, we're so low on life. These big creatures are just funny. Uh-oh. There we go. Where are they gonna come from? This is all set up. We got that set up. Turn this on. Turn that on. Oh my gosh, they're blowing up! All right, 15 seconds. Eight seconds. Come on. Oh my gosh. Grounded is a fun game. I played that for a while when I had my Xbox subscription for the PC. I remember it being, I just really liked it. It didn't have a lot yet for Grounded, but the little that I was able to play was really fun. I should visit it again. Pikmin. That is a game I've never played. And I feel like I should have by now. Oh, heavy punch attack. We don't have that yet. We can upgrade though. I thought you did have a Switch. Oh no, you have a, did you get the portable Steam? Alright, we're almost ready for that one rune. Let's go here, increase our damage. Increased damage is really good. We also should consider working on our tower. Nice. Let's go. I always heard good things about Pikmin games. We did play that one game. Some time ago, where it was similar to, supposedly it was similar to Pikmin, where we got little sprites and we used them. Oh, you did decide on a Switch. Okay. Yeah, my partner and I were on the fence for a Switch for a bit. Ended up getting one because we figured the kids would really like the games on the Switch and the mobile, being able to be mobile. And they absolutely love it. Especially my littlest. They have gotten really into Mario. Like hardcore love Mario and is obsessed with, ooh, we just unlocked Lucky Punch, is obsessed with Mario Maker. That is a fun game. Milk Bean is cool. That's a cool scroll. We'll take it. I'll have to try Pikmin. I've played games that were similar to it. So it's probably good to try the original. Where is a lamp? Ooh, that is scary over there. Oh, that'd be fun. Yeah, in the end, a Switch just seems like a good family game console. We had a PlayStation 4. I mean, we still technically have one, but, and they played that for a while. It's just, they weren't like in love with it. They kind of just made do. What we liked is we got two full controllers and we played Mario Party and stuff together. And then Mario Kart and all that. There's so many like family oriented games. It was really, it was a fun choice. All right, we're gonna see if we could bring both the toad, the lantern, and the rune. Oh, yours too? Yeah, mine is on the last legs. I want to get a PS5, but they're just so expensive. I just don't see the reason for it, outside of a few exclusive games. Alright, we're gonna put the rune there. Grab the lantern. Uh-oh, we left. Ooh. There we go. Yeah, the computer, a computer does make up made the decision of skipping a PS5 a little easier. And the Switch definitely is like a great choice for a family. We've been loving it, especially for like doctor's appointments and things, and when we go out and stuff, it's nice to have that option. Though we run into the problem, we have the two kids who both like it. So we might have to get like a Switch Lite. I don't think there's like a regular Game Boy anymore. Do they make just Game Boys anymore? Or do they just rely on Switches now? As the Game Boy. Like, it makes sense. A Switch is pretty good. And the Switch Lite is... It seems like it's pretty good as a mobile platform. But there was something nice about a small, compact gaming console. Like a Game Boy. Let's see, where is our temple? I mean, if as a argument for getting another one, we got the one, we got it as a family console, and I got myself, or my partner got me Animal Crossing for holidays, and we played it as a family, and my oldest took over my Animal Crossing island, my perfect well-manicured Animal Crossing island, and you could only have one island per console. So we actually thought about getting a Switch Lite just so we had our own console. So we had our own island. So totally agree with you there on the possibly needing one for yourself. Oh my gosh, things are getting nuts. Get cooked. So if you need confirmation that a second Nintendo Switch is worth it, I think it if it's within your budget, I'd say eventually you're probably gonna want to get one. Oh my gosh, that is a big Spidey. No more Spideys. I'm always for talking people into getting more gaming consoles for their families. The way I grew up with a gaming console in the living room, and my dad worked for the longest while. My dad worked as a soldering line for electronics, and would get all these different kind of gaming consoles back in the day when he was working there, and we always had one in the living room. And gaming became like a family thing. So I'm always for like more gaming consoles for the family to share. It was a good bonding experience. Yeah, that's actually what we were thinking about, a Switch and a Switch Lite. Cause you don't need the Switch. You don't need two Switches. You just need that extra Switch. And it doesn't necessarily have to be on the TV all the time. Okay, where is our last lantern? Okay, I think it's over here. Whee! Whoa, Nelly! Yeah, we totally considered that same setup. I'm still considering it. Mostly because we have two kids. Like two kids that they're the same, they're close in age. They're both into using the console. The only reason we're like things are a little easier is they have they both have their own cell phones. I mean, there are old cell phones when we upgraded, but and they're not technically phones anymore, but they do have phones that have some games on them. All right, we're gonna let you fill this up just a teeny bit. Yeah, we could go full. That was a tough level. Spider's trap. Oh, that's so cool. Yeah, my partner and I collect, we don't collect all consoles, but we do have a collection of old consoles. Mostly for nostalgia and just to have them for our kids to see the cool things that we used to have. Oh my goodness, why is everything killing me? I don't think I'd want one of every console though. But that'd be really cool to do. And Game Boys are fun. I like them. I still have my Game Boy Pocket and my red Pokemon. Those sustain me so much. I do miss my Game Boy Advance. I find it really funny. Oh no, not my Game Boy Advance. My Game Boy DS. I have a Game Boy. I have a Game Boy Pocket, which is just a slimmer black and white Game Boy. They came out a little bit after the old school Game Boy. And to this day, I still have it and it works perfectly. But my Game Boy DS and my Game Boy Advance, all broke. They did not last the test of time. Oh, jingle bells, we're dying. Okay, big thing dead. So what was your favorite console growing up? I always felt my favorite was the Genesis. But I think I put the most time in a PS1. But I have a lot of good fond memories around Sega Genesis. Give me that. Oh my gosh. And I'm doing this with a sore arm, guys. I am the flame keeper. Oh. I got a tetanus shot booster today. So my arm is just killing me. They always tell you it's not gonna hurt so bad. It'll probably be a little sore. It's not a little sore. It's a lot of sore. Oh, there's a lantern. Alright, this level is pretty spicy. Get away from me! No! We're dying! Alright, let's get our lantern. Oh, that's really far. Oh man, that's really far. We should be able to make it. Super Nintendo is good. I like me Super Nintendo. The fun thing, when I was growing up, I had a friend. They were a preschool, like we've known each other since preschool. And my family, we didn't have a lot of money, so like I couldn't get all the consoles I wanted to get. So I had to like really choose the console I wanted. And I ended up choosing Sega Genesis and PlayStation as my path into gaming. But my friend chose Nintendo. So I spent a lot of time at his house. So it was always like I grew up with all the systems, which was really nice. I liked the Super Nintendo though. It had a lot of fun games. Nintendo was always really good with that. It was always really good with their exclusives. In-house Nintendo games were always fun. Because you had the original Mario Kart. And But I think like my favorite Mario game was from all that was the Nintendo 64 Mario 64. Let's run. Most of my memories of playing Genesis, though, was a lot of Disney games. Okay, I think we need to go this way for the next lamp. What was your all-time favorite game on Super Nintendo? Into trees to get them to drop their goods. Oh, geez. Okay, we're gonna knock into this tree. I'll get the Volex things to come out for it. We don't have a rune, the rune. I kind of left it way out here. There it is. Unfortunately, we won't be able to jump. So we're gonna have to go the long way. It's my rune. No one can touch it. There we go. Get it. I'm curious. I just now realized there was no level difficulty select in this game. I wonder if I missed it. Dropping off some flames. Oh my gosh, these levels are getting so much bigger. Okay, that one we have. We went around that way, so our next one's probably out this direction. No, wait. Yes, okay. I was worried there for a minute. We need that sweet, sweet fire. Duck Hunt was a mood. That was one of the few games that actually like annoyed me. Like I love that. Don't get me wrong. I like Duck Hunt. The game's fun. That dog was annoying. Did you also try to shoot the dog? Donkey Kong was cool. Like that dog just pops up and snickering at you. Like it's doing any better. Oh my gosh. We have a lot of way to go. We have a distance to travel with this. With this lamp. You know what? I think we're gonna place the lamp. No, we got slowed. No, got slowed again. Suffer the wrath. Mega Man was a jam though too. I played the most, the one Mega Man I played the most was Mega Man for Game Boy. And that game made me so frustrated. When I was young, I was not good with hard games. I needed games that were more easier to play. Hard games made me upset. Which is funny because now it's like my favorite type of games are the ones that make me mad. No, you don't. Alright, let's get our lamp. I don't know where this other lantern is. I was hoping to get it while out. I guess not. Alright, that's that. Let's get number 4. If we can find it. Maybe it was over here. Oh, there it is. All right. The spider webs kind of give you a direction. Oh, there's signposts that tell you where to go. Here we go, last lamp. We got a distance to go. I love he just runs with this lamp, like hauling. He's hauling butt. Whoa, no, Natalie! We went the wrong direction. Okay, lamp. Oh no, we dropped it. Oh shoot, where did we drop it? Maybe. Oh, did we pass it again? Grab some fireballs while we're here. Okay, we were over here. Shit got real. Oh, it keeps making more of these things. No. You know, that serves me right. That serves me right. We were goofing around. I should have just kept moving. Get cooked! Ooh, the Me Strong rune. Oh man, you know what game I'd really love for them to bring back? Remember the old car battler games? Like Twisted Metal? I would love to see those things come back. They weren't good. Like, they weren't the most amazing games in the world, but there was something just special about them. I would like to see them, like, reimagined and brought back, like, using the technologies and game design sense that we have now. All right, this is attack speed. That's good. Get rid of the big one before we have a problem. Deal with the small ones too. So there was Twisted Metal. There was a second one. I can't remember what it was. Oh man, that's gonna drive me crazy. There was another one that was like Twisted Metal. And one of the things that I remember you could drive is a big old bus. And I only remember that because my youngest sibling would always pick the bus and just like wreck everybody's day. No! No! No, we've been poisoned! Okay, we're back in the game. We're back in the game. All right, lantern over here. No, we already got that lantern. We have two lanterns. Okay, this way. We also need to find a rune. Oh, that the Hot Wheels racing game? How is that game? If we're talking about the same one. It's like official Hot Wheels racing, right? Or something. But you like, it's, you're on Hot Wheels tracks and you race Hot Wheel cars. Like actual real models. Because my youngest is really, really likes Mario Kart. But also likes Hot Wheels on occasion. And I actually thought about that game a few times. Because you could drive the car, the Shark Hot Wheel. Which is one that I had. Oh yeah, Hot Wheels Unleashed. That is it. So it's a lot of fun. Is it just racing or like other game modes that you can play? I think they also have the like the Mystery Machine as a drivable car. Which That's a pro in my book. In just a minute here, I'll probably take my break, and I'm gonna look up that car battling game I'm thinking of. Cause I know it's not Twisted Metal. It's the other one. Back then, so many games were ripping each other off, so it was probably like something Twisted something too. Okay, we also need to get the rune. So we'll drop this off, hand over a little life force. I did see the rune this way. Out of my way! All right, we need to find the temple. Yeah, my youngest, they also, they're not like really strong at the racing games. They do okay, and have gotten better over the year, but his favorite thing is to turn the Mario Karts around and drive them backwards and just goof around. Too, so that's definitely a selling point. I'll have to look it up. I'm not like a huge racing game person, but the Hot Wheels one caught my attention. Just out of pure, it looked fun. If a racing game has a cool gimmick, I'm on board. Oh my goodness! All right, this is gone. We didn't find the temple. But we did get that, so that was good. We needed the seeds. Where's the temple? Not there. One thing I do like about Mario Kart is it does have a battle mode. Where you could drive the cars around and fight each other. Or play tag. So it does have those cool modes. Where? Temple. We need to find the temple. I'm okay with the shrine. I'm okay not getting the shrines, but we need the temple. The temple gives us acorns and thorns. Ah, we'll grab this. Seeds are okay too. Okay, we are running out of locations. Movement speed's good. It'll help us figure this out a little bit there. No! There it is. There we go. Temple found. Now we can go light up the campfire and get out of here. Badoom. We are gone. Oh, man. This is where we're gonna die. Again. Alright, so what did we learn? We need to get rid of the big things. Ooh. We're picking up some good runes here. Not enough to unlock, but working on it. Excuse me. Well, there's our rune. Do we see a temple around? We'll put the rune right there in the middle, just so it's easier to find. Regeneration's okay. Oh, I feel this is brutal. Let's do it. Open that up. We're gonna regenerate our life before we grab this. There we go. We'll open this too. Seeds are good to have around. Okay, no temple here. We're gonna drop that lamp here. We're actually gonna go find the next lamp. No, no, I accidentally pressed the wrong button. Okay, yeah, we're gonna grab this lamp too. Oh, if that's a knockback, I would, oh, it is, thank you. Yeah, we'll take that. Knockback is a good one to have. Alright, let's grab this. And we're gonna kind of like daisy chain our way to the camp. I don't know if this is faster, but it'll feel faster once we get to the campfire. Movement speed's good. Put that by the rune. Go for this one. Oh no, that's back. Excuse me, pardon me. Whoa! Bloop! Okay, regeneration is nice. And we could fill this up quite a bit. Oh! I didn't see them behind me! Let's go grab our other lamp, which we left right here. Very convenient. It's almost like I had a plan. Okay, we know the rune or the temple is not over here. So, because we know the temple's not over here, we'll grab the rune and try to find it. Along with the other lamps. Get cooked. Okay, this should be the right direction. If I remember this map. Grab that seed. Regeneration's good. Alright, there is our temple. Let's get this. Get this temple opened. No thorns. All acorns. I guess that's fine. Who needs thorns? In this part of the game. Not me. Alright, here's our last lamp. We're gonna hero rush into it. Bingo. Got it. Let's fill up just a little bit here. Almost there. Turn this in real quick. Then I think we're gonna jump on our last break for the night and we'll come back and hopefully we get to see a boss. I feel like we're getting close to what would be a boss fight. And I'm really interested in how they do boss fights in this game. Because that was not in the demo. Okay, that's empty. I don't want to go full in. Now we want to make sure our life is full. I don't want to go into a new level without life. Come on. Come on, fireballs. I mean, we'll get the seeds. It does set us back a little bit, but it's all right. All right, that should be enough. Oh, that's definitely. Grab this for good luck. Oh, perfect. Okay. Let's go to the next level and then to a quick break. And then we'll push on through. Man, we're unlocking so many achievements. All right. 3 minutes, I'll be right back for our final stretch of the night, and hopefully we get to see some boss action soon. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with a little more Flame Keep. Alrighty, let's do it. All right, let's do this tower defense. We got a good ability to keep us a little bit safe, but I'm not sure. Oh my, okay. So there's 2-3 paths. All right, they're all fairly straightforward, it seems. Come on. Getting one of these on the full path done right now would be great. Do I want Berserker? I don't. The spiders follow me. We just gotta be careful with the beagle guys. Tower online. We'll get this tower online too. There we go. None down that middle path, it looks. Weird. Yeah, none down here yet. Oh, spoke to me. Here they come. I'll fight you in the canals. Oh man, they're coming from everywhere. We got some on the left. Oh, big boys on the left. Please be dead. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh no! Bad mushrooms! Bad mushroom trip! Okay, where is... Okay, it's the final countdown. The final countdown. Sorry, I will re-chat in just a second here. 15 seconds to be exact. No, stop eating that! Stop eating the sweet fires! Highly focused. Spider trap? Oh, this seems like a boss level. I mean, my stream is pretty amazing. I would have thought the same thing. Cookies, I'd want cookies. I mean, who doesn't want cookies? Okay. Spider boss, huh? It looks cute. It's adorable. It's not horrifying at all. Yeah, it looks like we've met our spider boss friend. Oh my gosh. Okay, we can't attack it when it's glowing green. It seems to be shielded. Oh my gosh, where did you... No. This wasn't a part of the deal. Actually, we'll take melting. Oh my gosh, it knows where I'm going. How does it know? What? No, why? No. I don't like it. I want to go home. Unfortunately, we have to fight to generate health. All right, we're gonna try to farm some health. We'll let it generate some spiders and we'll punch him. Oh my gosh. We needed the health. Ooh, pacifist number two. Jeez. It knows like where you're going. Come on, spider die. Oh my gosh. Please be dead. Oh my gosh, thank you. Better energy. Oh Lord. Spider boss was real. What is this? Yes. Gather my little children. The little gremlins, they invade. Well, that's terrifying. We need to make ourselves stronger. Better. We don't have enough for that. How are we in the tower defense realm? Ooh, we don't have spikes. Oh, the village is getting better, bigger. Okay, we do have Lucky Punch. This gives us a 10% chance of 200% critical hit. We'll take that. If we have some more unlocked, we definitely grab another one here. Dirty South. Okay, so is Dirty South open now? Windy Biome, Jagged Plains. Oh, ooh, okay, so the Jagged Plains gives us the biome resource of acorns. This gives us the biome resource of thorns. This one mushrooms, and then this one's unknown. Let's check out the Windy Desert. And just so I keep saying it's a full release, it's actually an early access release. I don't want to misrepresent the game. It is an early access release. So some stuff is going to be kind of locked out. Which is nice. There's some stuff I'd like to recommend in this game. Oh! Hello, scorpions! So far, everything in the game I like. But there are a few quality of life stuff I'd like to see. Oh my gosh, poison is a nightmare. Have you seen the gear wheel anywhere? Whoa! Whoa! What is over there? So if we find a gear wheel, will we be able to see what's behind that, what that thing is? So we can't go in there, we'll die. But there's like this big old beetle. One-eyed beetle. What is this nonsense? Alright, we got a longer dash. That one's gonna be a good one to... A good rune to pick up. Oh, here's the gear wheel. Okay, let's bring this back to our friend. Here you go, my friend. Oh my gosh. Oh, wow. The worlds are weird in this game. It's interesting, right? So it's not like a dungeon crawl. The levels are actually a little more complicated than a dungeon crawl. It's similar to like how Tunic kind of had its little worlds built out. Where it was a little kind of roughly free roaming in a way. Oh, this isn't good. This isn't good. Regenerate would be really good. Movement speed's fine. Oh man, now we're gonna have to bring this back. All right, let's put this here. This might be a horrible idea. All right, there's a rune. I mean, our temple. So we need the rune to get that temple open. I'm glad that gets them while they're underground. It's super helpful. Alright, there is our other lamp. No, thank you. Oh. I like these guys. No. They give a lot of health. Okay, this is gonna be a risk, but we're gonna take it. I got it, y'all. Gain weight, man. All right, how are we gonna do this? Oh, this is gonna suck. So, oh man. We gotta do this one lamp at a time, I think. You know what? We have to go back here anyways. So, for the rune, or the temple for the, once we find the runes. So we will actually just leave that lamp over there. Because what we'll do is come back with the rune for the temple. Oh my gosh. We'll come back with the rune for the temple, and then when we're leaving, we'll grab the lamp. That's two. There is our ethereal. And our room. All right, we'll unlock this. Please don't shoot at me. We'll leave that there. Drop this off. Go get our last lamp. And then all we have to do is think, plan on how to get some health. Armor spear you. No! Look at that guy, he's so cute! In an evil beetle kind of way. Ooh, regeneration's good here. There is our temple. Grab these seeds while we're at it. Ah, yes, the spikes. So we will have to go to the pass level if we want to get more and more of more upgrades and stuff. We need to get more acorns too. Very interesting. Careful. Careful now. There we go. No! No! Bad trip! No, it's a bad trip! Oh no! Oh, bad mushroom trip. That was not good. You gotta be careful with the mushrooms. You gotta be careful with the mushrooms. You never know where that trip's gonna take you. Okay, let's get some health. This might actually take a hot minute because there's not a ton of trees. Our best bet here would probably get a regenerate. Come on, gather around. There we go. I gotta get the seeds. That's fine. There we go. That's what I want. Regenerate's gonna help us here. Okay, now let's try not to die. Good. No, I want to regenerate again. That would have been perfect. Okay. Do we? Yeah, I guess we do. Let's just go. Ideally, we would have waited, but we're gonna risk it. No, the risk didn't pay off. I kind of like Hammer Strike. Hammer Strike's actually pretty decent. Pretty powerful when it hits. You do have to set it up. Oh man, we're getting a lot of bits and pieces of runes, but we're not getting the main events. Completed pieces. We'll take this. No, you don't. No, you don't. All right, that's where the gear goes. Get wrecked. Big rock guy. There you go, my friend. All right, let's grab this lamp. This makes a lamp number two. Three more lamps to go. There's our rune. Which, this seems to be set up where the rune temple is gonna be across the Windy Way. So let's grab this. Spiders or scorpions. All right, there's our lamp. No, we lost it. That's all right, we got this. Oh, I feel bad punching those guys. I really feel bad doing it. All right, that one has a spider in it. We'll leave it alone. We don't want that spider mess. Oh, that one has a spider in it too. Okay, leave that there. Grab the rune. Because it must be down here, then. It is! There we go. All right. Rune in temple. Give me them spikies. Now we can get the lamps. So our second lamp is up here. Guarded by a rock man. Frogman's not too bad once we start figuring him out. Grab this. Now we gotta get two of these lamps across, which should be okay. No! 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 Doing it. Is this more effective or efficient? Probably not. I feel like it is, and we're gonna attempt. Oh my gosh, Rockman! Fortunately, the enemies can't. Oh my gosh, they can't come after us. No! No! I'm really worried now about getting a trip. We're just gonna grab this. We'll ignore him. He's not that tough. There we go. Now we just got. Well, fudge. Oh no. Oh no. That was not how I wanted that to end. Oh well, though. All right, let's do some upgrading, and I think we're going to call it a night. Oh man. I think we need to upgrade this. Well, we don't have enough for that yet. Increased dash damage and power punch, huh? Let's do power punch. Combo dash. A punch landed immediately after dashing causes more damage. Interesting. And what's a stomp? Powerful smash attack from above. Huh. Let's get... Well, we already got power punch. Let's get the stomp and a little bit more power on our dash attacks. We don't have enough for here yet either. South. Okay. I think we're good. Because I also don't think we have runes. So this isn't going to do us much good. We're not going to unlock any slots until... Alright. This is, though, where we're going to stop. Because I need to go to bed. And, yeah. Mostly because I need to go to bed. Alright. Though, so this was Firekeeper. I really like Firekeeper. I think there's some things about it that need to grow that I hope they start adding more into it. So I'm gonna definitely try to get my thoughts out to the developer and stuff, if I can, through their Discord or Twitter or something. Because hopefully they're accepting of commentary and suggestions and stuff as they grow bigger. So I really liked it. It is currently on sale right now. Just so you know, if you want to give Firekeeper a try or just add it to your library as an early access deal, it is currently on sale for like $8. I think it's a really good deal for this type of game. And as it grows bigger, I think it is definitely going to be worth the amount. So if you can, if you really thought this was an interesting game, snagging it for $8 is pretty good deal. It's not completed yet, and not all the biomes are going to be unlocked. But as the game grows more and more, they'll be available later on. So if you think you're going to be interested in it, definitely worth the price. With that said, though, thank you for being here and hanging out with me. We will be back on Wednesday at 9:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time with more Firekeeper. We're gonna try to get through the desert area of Firekeeper and try to complete as much of the biomes as we can and do some upgrading and stuff. So we'll be back on Wednesday, 9:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time with more Firekeeper. And then on Friday, we'll be doing our indie first look. We actually have three games from the Indie Game Collective for the IGC showcase. So this Friday first look will be presented by the IGC showcase. So that's going to be really exciting because it's three games from the collective. So that's really cool. And then if you are looking for more of my indie first looks, you don't have to go that far. You could actually go to YouTube and check that out, because there is exclusive to YouTube indie first looks on there. The big difference between those, they're a little shorter, and I use a PNG tuber instead of my face because it's just a lot easier to record a whole bunch of videos not being my best. So check those out if you want. And always check me out on Twitter for latest updates and news and stuff and just random yammerings. But that is it for me tonight. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you guys have a good rest of the night and a good tomorrow. And I will be back on Wednesday. I hope to see you then soon. Always remember, keep your heart open and your rolls 20. And I will see you guys next time. Good night, everyone.